Well, I grew up in what was then the Jim Crow South, and I grew up in the country. My parents were sharecroppers. By the time I reached the eighth grade, a couple of the teachers talked to my father and said that I had such great potential, it was a shame that I had to miss all that school. So my dad made an executive decision. He decided that me and my siblings would no longer have to miss school. I arrived at the University of Washington on September 7th, 1967. I was the only black student out of 43 students who entered the graduate school in chemistry. But I went to the hub in search of blacks. I was coming from an all-black school. I was looking for people who looked like me and were like me. And lo and behold, as you walk into the door, there are two tables, all black students sitting there. And so students met there, they had discussions, they played cards, they argued, but it was community. It was a small community. Back then, we found out later that there were probably 30 black graduate students and a total of 180, 200 black students all together in an enrollment of 30,000 students.
The Odegaard Award at the University of Washington recognizes an individual who has had a significant impact on diversity on campus and in our community.
This year, we're excited to recognize our very own Emil Petrie as the recipient of the Odegaard Award. Emil Petrie has 5 decades of excellence and service to this university, but most importantly, the students. He's so passionate about the instructional center, but also the students that come through it.
So he has done more than just change the face of the university. He has changed the DNA of the university.
He was first a student when he came here, I believe, for his master's, and then, you know, was one of the original, you know, founders of the Black Student Union. But he was also a champion for Native students. He was a champion for everyone. And so I think that, you know, later he did work for, obviously, the IC, and he was a big proponent of students there. Then he was working for Office of Minority Affairs. So he's done everything. But the underlying theme throughout it, his career was, you know, focusing on making it better for other people.
I felt like we were going to make a difference. We were also not only fighting for the inclusion of other black groups, but also other ethnic groups, like American Indian, and back then, Chicanos. So it was pretty exciting. We were tough, and we took no guff from anyone. We didn't feel influenced by what people thought of us because we had our goal set on changing the face of diversity at this institution.
You know, when I think about the impact he's had on our campus and, you know, changing the way we use data to make decisions and supplemental instruction for students and in terms of helping them get through gateway courses, identifying even that gateway courses was a impediment for student success at the University of Washington. He did that.
It was supporting people no matter what they needed, no matter where they were at. It was supporting the person, not the student. And I think there's a big distinction there. So Emil cares about the people. He doesn't care about whether they're getting an education per se. He cares about whether they're developing themselves and reaching their potential.
Emil believes in students, and he believes in the power of community.
You look at the number of students that he's touched and the way he's guided these students into these incredible careers and sort of life paths and also made them strong, engaged alums and engaged community members who like Emil have this obligation to make a difference. So
I would have not been able to succeed at all without the help that I got specifically from Emil, but also from the Instructional Center in general. And I think that he should be so proud of the work that he did with all of us kids.
When you think about what it means to live in a civil society, I think of individuals like Emil. That's truly the sort of the gold standard, what it means to be a citizen and living a life that matters, I think. You know, having that impact is so key. And if we could all do just a little bit of that, imagine how different the world would be now.
Thank you, Emil, for your leadership, service, and friendship.
Emil, thank you. I owe everything to you, and so do a lot of us.
Thank you, Emil, for your investment in me.
Thank you, Emil. The time that you spent with me at the Instructional Center changed my life and allowed me to pursue the passions of teaching in my life, and it's meant the world to me. Thank you so much.